Hang on a minute, guys. I'm having a bit of a technical issue with my streaming software. So if you guys could just give me about 2 minutes. I'll be able to tell me if I do it like this or if I need to take more drastic measures. Okay, give me one more minute. I guess I really need a testing stream, huh? Sorry. Alright, it seems to be working fine. Just give me 30 more seconds. Got people showing up for this, of all things. Whatever. Alright. Alright then. Let's get this show on the road. Oh, 21XX. Oh, good. We don't have to worry about the Sigma thing anymore. Why is there foreboding music? Something like that probably wouldn't last long. After a few months, what? I suspect the translation wasn't the best. Oh. Uh-oh. Thank you. Alright. Let's get this third game started. First things first, I like to change my dash to be L. Let's get started. I'm gonna be honest, X1 is the favorite. I have a soft spot for this game, though. Got a bit of a soft spot for this game. I kind of like the I kind of like looking around for the upgrades in this game. HP bar. Yes! Yes! Ow. Alright, I'm gonna be honest, it's probably one of the few times you see me use zero. And don't get me wrong, he's... Here's the problem with Zero. You only get one life for him. He dies, you don't get to use him for the rest of the game. Ah, oh, look at Smack. Oh man, I never even got to use the sword on him. Yeah, as far as Zero's concerned, compared to X, he's got the sword. He's got basically X2's Buster upgrade, and he's got 6 heart tanks. Otherwise, he's base and oh yeah, he's got a bigger hitbox. Otherwise, he's basically the same as X. Why is it always these giant mechs that get destroyed so quickly? Watch. So quickly. Why? How are these things less durable than the Reploids? How? Now it just fell to pieces. Call me if you need me. And that is actually a mechanic in this game. You can actually call on Zero, but... Well, there's two big things. One, you can only use him until you get to a boss or a mini-boss door. Meaning, at most, he'll cover one-third of the stage. The other issue with him? One life. You lose Zero, you don't get to use him for the rest of the game. And he is needed for... And you will... And for a certain upgrade, you do need him alive. But... I don't think we need to worry about that for a while, so... Yeah, somehow... Shield Penguin? Ice is no problem. Blizzard Buffalo? Suddenly it's a problem. Don't know why. Can't grab that yet. I swear, take it. X takes way more damage in this game. And enemies are more likely to activate, to spawn in if you go off screen. Like, I know in the first game you could go a little bit off screen and they won't respawn, but in this game, they'll respawn very quickly. If you go even the slightest bit off screen. In the first two games, there was also a glitch that. There was also a glitch that allowed that meant that any uncharged shots fired while he was dashing would do double damage, but they cut that in this game. Unfortunately, they cut that in this game, so. I want to bring Zero out for this because I need the fact that he's slightly bigger. And again, you only get to use him once per stage. One thing I didn't mention is that you only get to use him once per stage anyways. There we go. Look at that capsule, but it won't do anything if Zero. But it won't do anything for Zero. Actually, hold on. Slightly. So now I switch back to X. And this. Give me the leg upgrade, so that means I've got the air dash back. And actually, this one's a straight upgrade over X2. Ooh, because it lets you dash straight up. This one, dashing straight up's a little finicky though. If you tap left or right while you're dashing upwards, it'll actually cancel the dash, meaning you'll start falling straight down. Like, that's normal, right? Oh, never mind. It must be, now. Come on, I just need to get back to the start of this section. Nope. Okay, never mind. I think you just need to hold the button down. Thank you. There we go. Ow. Again, half the problem with this game is that it's probably also the hardest, because I swear X takes way more damage in this game than he does in the others. On the other hand, Blizzard Buffalo is rather easy, if you can avoid getting hit by him. And yes, that is important, because he hurts. Buffalo really hurts if he manages to... Oh, that's gonna hurt. Yeah. Yeah, as you can see, he does a lot of damage if he hits you. Ugh. I know there's a glitch that caused him to dash in the other direction, but I don't know quite how to activate it. There we go. First boss down. Yeah, something you probably notice about most of the music tracks is that most of them have this grunge guitar thing. It's hit or miss. I mean, that kind of rocking out works better with the Genesis than it does the SNES. The SNES can make it work. I mean, the SNES port of Doom had decent music. Or if we can get past the graphics and frame rate. Because trust me, the graphics and frame rate for those games were... Oh no. Boss. mini boss was disappointingly easy. Also, it has the same repetitive. So, as far as music is concerned, it does have the same repetitive problem X2 has. Whoa. Switch weapons. Another problem with this game is that if you use the right weapon, the bosses are weak. Like, just watch what happens to Toxic Seahorse here, and you'll see what I mean. Yeah, no. This is literally like the Toad Man fight from Mega Man 4. Yeah, no. Yeah, no. That's just ridiculous. Alright, your next weapon of choice is... Get... What's this? This time. Oh. Oh. Hello. That must be the quirky mini boss squad. Oh no, I have no idea who that is. Oh no. That's not a good sign. Alright. So that quirky mini boss squad is something I'm gonna start encountering now. I encounter the small one first, then the big one. That's about a quarter of my health gone. You take a lot more damage in this game than you do in the others. But I don't even get what the point of these are. I agree that they actually slowed you down, but all they do is just annoy you. Oh, look, a heart tank. I can't get to that yet, though. Thank you. if that's what that does. I at least grabbed the other sub tank. Yeah, unfortunately, I won't be able to start grabbing most of the upgrades until later. Yeah, he always tries to match. Ow. He always tries to match you on the way down. Okay. Now I'm gonna switch back to the old weapon. See, if I destroy him using the frost shield, I'll actually destroy him. But I don't want to destroy him. This will change a boss later on. If I leave either Bit or Bite alive, it'll change a boss later on. I'm going to leave both of them alive. As for that mysterious Maverick, I'm destroying him. Which is the same deal as these two, but I want to destroy him for a different reason. Oh, man, I'm at low health. Not anymore. Yeah, I've got some HP. I still get why they just put these things here, man. Oh! Yeah, I can't go that way yet. Time, he's weak to this. No, wait. It's not boss time yet. It's just a mini boss. I don't think. You know, I don't think they talk about unfortunate design choices. That's just unfortunately designed. I've already been. Are you serious? Do I have to fight that mini boss again? Honestly, compared to this guy's easy. Like, this guy's really easy. Of course, he'll do a lot of damage on me. You know what? I really don't want to die here. Yeah, no. He does have another attack where he shoots drills. He rarely uses it. Now, this boss is not actually weak to Tunnel Rhino's weapon, but there's an upgrade here that requires me to have Tunnel Rhino's weapon, which is why I'm going here. There we go. Now I die on purpose to exit the level. I got what I came for. this is the boss I need next. That right armor from the last stage, it's me. Now use right armor on any stage. I need it to stomp down there. Because that's my third sub tank is. That's pretty much the only real use for the right armor. There's actually four different right armor variants, but I won't. Yeah, Tornado Fang, it's just not fair. Yeah, no. Weapons really trivialize bosses. Like, if you thought X1 was bad about this, X1 and X2 were bad about this, X3 really turns it into an art form. Or at least they kind of go overboard in making sure the bosses are weak to their weapons. That's literally what it does. Kind of like a shield. By the way, if I get the right armor destroyed, I won't be able to just grab another one, unfortunately. Oops. Next one over. Yeah. Here it is. Good stuff. Okay, pinky caps has to do with this one. Well, see, four of the levels have regular caps, have the regular blue caps. It's those upgrade X's. You probably have no idea what he's talking about right now. Don't worry, you will soon. That's the thing about the pinky capsules. They can only take one enhancement chip at a time. However, for the best results, you actually don't want to grab any of the ones in the any of the pink capsules in the stages. I'll show you why later. Grab the blue ones, avoid the pink ones. And actually, most of them you need the upgraded part. You need to grab the corresponding blue capsule. So I can't grab that. So I straight up cannot grab that yet. Yeah. I'll be back. Thankfully, this level is actually rather short. This isn't really a mini boss. What it does do, however, is stage on its head. I This boss is still probably gonna hurt me a lot, though. Okay, never mind, I think I might have just found a way to break this boss. Yes, they do mainly go backwards. Yeah, it's kinda nuts. Okay. The one I really want to hit is over here. I don't even know why they brought these back in. Also, all they do is really waste time. Air dash boost. And oh, look, a blue capsule, and this one is four. The arm cannon upgrade. Shoot two charge shots at once. It's not quite like X2's. Yeah, you can hit. You can. It pretty much makes a much bigger charge shot, but it's not exactly worth it. On the other hand. You get the charge special weapons again, so that's always nice. Yeah, if you do that. It usually takes way too much time to properly up. Thanks. Oh yeah. You also get to climb. You also climb through things much faster now. It also lets you climb ladders much faster now. Four charge levels. You can tell because the last one's red. Because it goes like blue, orange, pink, red. Oh, thank you very much. You can see what I mean about the music, right? Let's grab right armor. If I switch to zero, I won't be able to hit these guys with uncharged shots. And here's my heart tank. Yeah, no, pretty much all the bosses are like this. Actually, I'm really happy I've got the upgrade, the X-Buster upgrade. Crawfish's stage. Because there's a this special there I kinda need. Okay, first things first, you see this? You wouldn't normally equate an electric type attack with an earthquake. If I'm right, it's something involving a myth, a Japanese myth involving catfish and earthquakes. I'm not quite sure what the details are, I'm afraid. But that's what I've heard. I mean, if you remember the Wish Cash Pokemon? There we go. Oh, that's an interesting looking teleporter. Well, there's a reason for this. For the record, this elevator wouldn't be working if I had... This elevator's only working because I took out Bold Catfish. Oh wait, it's Vile in the... Hang on, that's right armor. Uh-oh. Himself is weak to this too. Fuck this. Thank you. dasher yet. X, why are you not jumping? That's just embarrassing. That's actually just embarrassing. You know what? I'll be right back. There's some upgrades I can grab in this place that'll make what to do just a little bit easier. Grab these two upgrades later, but normally I grab the helmet first, but in this case, oh wait, this is the helmet upgrade. Oh. Okay, no, this one is honestly really helpful for finding items. Download and upload a map. If I had any power-ups missing, there would be red dots and there would be red circles in each of those squares. But that's not what's going on, so. Alright, I'm done here. This is honestly a really good item to get, because it'll now tell me what upgrades I have and don't have. The ones I don't have are in pink. Alright. Let's see if I can take on Vile again. Wait. Why is there no green ship? What am I doing? I've got a way to get to one. Skip this by just like tapping. See, this is another way to get to Vile's. For the record, I won't be able to access this once I take out all the Mavericks, so go. Back. Splasher. We go. I think that this is the end. Hold on, he's slowing down. It will haunt you to the day you... Oh, I think we got him. Look, he's slowing down. Yeah, we got him. Except... Now we gotta hustle. Well, guess what? He did plant explosives in this place, so... And now these things get a lot more... So they're actually doing a pretty good job in slowing us down. Okay. Okay, we're done here. Thankfully, we're now done with this level. For good. Right, the next one we need is... right up here. Okay, this theme I actually like. You know what? Yeah, first it's just gonna tell us where the upgrades are. I won't be able to get that one on the left. I should be able to get the other two at least, though. No, I should be able to get one of the other... No, I should be able to get the one over there. I don't need the one up there. I think that's a ship part. And that's time for me to... You know what? I'm gonna do something I haven't done in a while. Come on. Pull in zero. It's been too long. If he gets a low health or if I'm afraid he's gonna die, I'm switching back to Hex. I also wanna show off one more thing. You can see the helmet upgrade. You can see the helmet upgrade on it. Helmet and body upgrades on X when you get them, and you see them in this picture. Okay. So quite frankly, he still gets to do the dash move thing. Oh no, he doesn't get to do that. Ow. Nope. But he can't air dash. And as you see, as they get close to the boss door, X jumps in. And then, you can't switch back to him, you only get one usage of him per stage. Another elevator, thankfully this one is kind of skippable. This one's an amphibious one. This one can fly and has a projectile. Needless to say, I have no reason not to use this one. So you can fly from it, and it fires rockets! Is another pink capsule. We don't need those. Yeah, no, this is just... Normally I'll do the rematches without the weakness weapons. Okay, except for Blizzard Buffalo, I did that one first. Can't grab that one because I need to do the, the next boss's stage in order for me to access that upgrade. back here for the body upgrade. See, it's not going down anymore, so. Up here, the only way to bring this up is to do this. And this will give me the last upgrade. Get out of here. Anything in there? Just the chip in there. I'll need to go back in there. Let's deal with this first. And now I can finally get to this boss. Don't need that red dot over there. That's a pink capsule, and that'll kind of ruin my day. Well, actually, I don't need the pink capsule. Yeah, no, it does actually decrease the amount of damage I take. So let's see if Zero can grab this. Oh, he can't use the right armors either. But yeah, as you can see, the armor shows up on X's portrait too. It's this boss. Yeah, I think it jumps whenever you hit it. Go. but I have to fight that boss again, don't
I? I don't. Huh.
Oh, right, the other one. Bite. This guy is kinda ridiculously easy. Like, just watch this. This is literally all he does. I mean, if he catches me, it's gonna hurt. For the record, that mine he's attached to the walls pushes me away from the wall. That's literally it. It's just what? I think I'm probably better off firing off my charge shots. Yeah, no, it doesn't miss. Parasitic bomb. Yep. And well, I just need to pick up a couple of last upgrades. And once that's done, well, I can start picking up the two secret upgrades in this game. Yeah, unlike in X1 and X2, there's only one secret upgrade, that being the Street Fighter reference moves. X3's actually got two upgrades. Two secret upgrades. But one of them you get just like the Shoryuken in X2. Thankfully, you get that one much earlier. The second one requires a couple of conditions to be met. The first one is that you need Zero alive. Second one is that you need to destroy Vile. The third one I'll get into when we get to it. As for what it does, well, you'll see.
could go and engage with the lab now. But I still have a few things to grab. So there's a reason why I couldn't grab the upgrade here first, and here's why. I needed to destroy Blast Corner to get access to this upgrade. It's not the weapon that's needed here, it's the fact... it's these boxes. I destroyed Blast Corner, I don't have to worry about these boxes anymore. Nope, I still can't. Also, it makes these enemies much, much less smart. Remove the homing from their rockets, and... let's get out of this one. So I figure I might as well talk about each of the enhancement ships. So, I know there's the body upgrades, but there's also a bunch of enhancement ships, too. If you get the body upgrade for its respective chip, if you get the body upgrade, you can get its respective chip too. The thing is, you can only upgrade, you can only have one body upgrade at a time. So, for example, getting the heads upgrade ship would get me a... would allow me to regenerate health while standing still. The nice thing about this health regeneration, though, is that it also happens to affect the sub-tanks, so I can refill the sub-tanks. So I can refill the sub-tanks by standing still. The bodies will increase the power of the energy shield. The foot parts will increase the effectiveness of the air dash, allowing me to air dash twice instead of just once. And yes, I can use both of them to go upwards, so that's kind of nuts. And that leaves us, and then the arm cannon one. So, X2 had the Giga Crush, which filled up by taking damage. Now, X3 puts the Giga Crush equivalents into his... whoops. But what this upgrade does... well, what this upgrade's supposed to do is that it gives me a bar that charges up just like the Giga Crushes by taking damage. When it's full, I can expend it to fire charge shots over and over. I mean, the way a charge shot works in this game, it's kinda impractical. For the most part, there is one situation where it can come in handy. There is one situation where the hypercharge comes in handy. And it involves the upgrade that involves Zero. So yeah. I need this specific part though to grab this next one, because, believe it or not, the ride armors, for the most part, are not amphibious, except for this one. Last upgrade. Yep. 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 Uh-huh. That's fine. Got everything. Yep. Alright. It's time. There's a reason why I missed those chips, those pink chip parts on purpose. Honestly, I really like this stage theme. Full health supply on this part. Okay, now if I go down here... Yep. And this is why I didn't get the body... didn't get any of the chips. So if you remember what I said about the body chips, that the head one gives me HP regen, the body one increases my defense, the arms one gives me the hypercharge, and the legs one gives me the double air dash, right? Well, if you don't grab any of them, you grab this particular chip. What does this one do? Well, it gives me all of them. And it turns Mega Man's armor gold to boot. See? Double air dash. Hypercharge. HP regen. As you can see, I've got a red energy shield now instead of a blue one. Does strengthen that. Honestly, this is probably my favorite armor to work with in this series. Like, I know most people swear by the ultimate armor, but I actually prefer the golden version of the third of X3's armor. Is there anything up here? I don't know what the point of this is. So I want this. Yeah, you can still see Mega Man's armor does still change colors. This. Hey, it's these two. We've been waiting for you, X. They have. Now, And I'm not gonna. I am technically gonna fight them both at the same time. It's just the way it works is a little bit different. They fuse. Now, if I only killed. Now, if I only destroyed one of them, I'd still have to deal with this boss. But this boss is quite frankly. Okay, this boss is quite frankly piss easy. Yeah, no. For the record, if I had destroyed both of them, I'd be fighting a different boss here. That's why I left them alive. Yeah, it did. Then again, I wasn't really trying to dodge the attacks. Now, the reason why I had... Now, the thing is, this stage would actually be a little bit different if I had let Vile live. But I didn't, so... Yes, I get to use right armor, but I'm not. Yep, now we got another underwater area. Okay. This is what the third requirement is. The first requirement for this, kill, destroy Vile. Second requirement, have Zero alive. This is the third requirement. I need to, see, normally X would stop me going into the boss room, but with this, X won't stop me. And in case you're wondering, no, he doesn't get any different looks. So I'm just gonna preemptively charge the saber. That thing will collide onto Zero if I go for it. You're probably wondering why I let Zero take this hit. Well, here's why. That's not a joke. I get to use Zero's sword in this game, as X. And quite frankly, X's uses of this puts Zero to shame. Because he actually gets the sword beam. Apparently, if I had gone to this part without, if I had done this without the arm upgrade, if I had done this with the arm upgrade, I'd get the arm upgrade for free. Okay, this stage does have an annoying part. This. Yeah, see, I even got the health regen. Yeah, this is gonna take a while. Unfortunately, the only things I really have to boost my mobility right now is pretty much just the double air dash. Give you an idea of just what the beam saber does to bosses. So I'm just gonna keep this charged. For the record, if I had destroyed Vile, not only would the stage be slightly different, I'd be fighting Vile here and not this octopus thing. Yeah, it does that. Beam Saber does a lot of damage. Not as much as the Hadouken, sure you can, but on the other hand, you don't need to be at full health, and you don't need to do the button input, the command inputs for them. Alright. For a moment, because I just want to recover that HP. Okay. I can damage this thing, so it'll drop power-ups. You know, if it'll finally drop me health. Okay, I've got two full E-tanks. I'm going to do... Wait, is this Blizzard Buffalo? Yeah. You know what? I didn't show this off, using this off against him. So I'm gonna do just that. And he's not doing nearly as much damage. The only boss I was gonna do with the upgrade weapon. All the others I'm just gonna use the regular buster. Might give you more of an idea of what they were supposed to do. Well, until they get a sword to the face. Alright. First off, I'm just gonna stand still for a bit, let my HP recover. I could use this to fill my sub tanks, but I feel like that'll take a little too long, so. That's toxic spores. Okay. For the record, if you were planning on doing this without the golden armor, I'd personally suggest using the headship. Interestingly enough, while the game itself will only let you select one, if you were to... You could use codes to input up to 3 of the chips under normal circumstances. Same palette as the explosions. Okay. Let's just heal up the last 2 bits of my health. 1, 2. Unfortunately, it's not really worth trying to come into these charging. Uh-oh, this guy. There we go. Another saber down. So I'll just heal this part off. What do you expect? Thank you. Oh, joy. This guy. Oh, yeah, see, he's got he's using the drill attack now. Wrong way. Yeah, but the sword is kind of ridiculous. I'm just gonna wait a bit and let my health refill. So Doppler's honestly rather easy. He's only got two attacks and a defensive, an interesting defensive option. Then again, I think he's a scientist, not a. He's not gonna say yes. What? So watch this. See? He's healing, right? You can only really hit him when he's throwing attacks out. That one, he just flies that way. Bugger. Yeah, no, that's literally all he does. That's why you try and hit him with the sword. The sword part of the beam saber. Sizzle. man is basically collapsed. And now we know how he keeps coming back. Yeah, notice, I'd like you to notice how he doesn't go kaboom. Keep that in mind. Alright, last boss time. Huh. Sigma and a tank. Making multiple bodies for Sigma. I'm just gonna stand still for a minute. So I should be able to bring a charge shot in with me. So I'm just gonna stand still for a minute to recover what's left of my health, because I might need it. Yeah, wall jump up. And look who it is. Sigma, with... Yes, that is a shield. In the first game, he used a sword. In the second game, he used Wolverine claws. In this game, he uses a shield like he's Captain America or something. What is it with Sigma and taking other people's weapons? No, really. If you know anything about Sigma, this isn't over yet. This isn't over yet, guys. I think you guys already knew that. Huh? The ultimate battle body. Apparently, the main problem Sigma had with using this thing is that there's not enough space for him to use it. Another thing. I want you to keep in mind, what do you think? His weakness is not his head. It's actually those two fins above his head. So I'm gonna pop in a tank. Second thing is, hypercharge time. I might as well show this off. Wait. Yeah, it's literally just charge shot spam. I'm out of hypercharge. Use one more sub tank. There we go. A apparently this body is actually really dangerous if it had the space to move around in it. Sigma pulled it out in a tight quarter, but I'm not quite done here yet. One last thing I need to do. Sigma, that won't actually work. Oh hey, it's the Sigma virus. Unfortunately, I don't have a strike chain. Quite frankly, I don't think I can hit it. That's actually the end of the game. I'm not actually controlling X here. Unfortunately, we walked right into a dead end. Sorry. Oh, and look, it's the Sigma virus. Give up X. Oh, that would not be good. Except... oh, hey, it's Doppler. What's he doing? Ah, he's got a seg back. He's made a vaccine for the Sigma virus. And you still have to get rid of Sid. There's the explosion you're all looking for. Yeah, the text is kind of slow. By the way, if Zero was still well, alive, he would actually be in this ending as well, and it'll change a couple of things. But I wanted the swords, so I'm probably gonna make another video for this on YouTube, showcasing this ending with Zero, as well as the two bosses I missed. But that'll be later. Yeah, they had to they recycled quite a few enemies throughout the stages. To be fair. From right, X2 and X3 are kind of used a special chip to pull off the wireframe graphics. And used them very sparingly compared to, say, Star Fox. For instance, because I think that's the best example I can show off. Well, I don't think I'm going to be doing X4 as my next game. I mean, I do have access to it, but I want to wait a bit before I go and try and play another X-Series game. What I want to do is maybe either Doom or Star Fox. Again, I've got a suggestion box if you scroll down a bit, so maybe suggest something for me to play there. And I'll and if I have access to the game, I'll probably give it a shot. That's one of the bosses I missed. Yep, various right armor kinds. And now we get to the boss reel. Again, this game isn't considered as good as the first two, but I have a bit of a soft spot for this game, if I'm gonna be honest. It's the exploration aspect. Also, I like the hidden upgrades more than the other two games. But that's my personal feelings. And that's the name of that boss that was the fused forms of both Bit and Byte. Sigma and... Yeah, at the bottom, the big body was Kaiser Sigma. Again, he can't really make the most of it because he was in such a small space. Sigma fires the wireframe thing. Yeah, that's usual. And you, the flare. Thank you for watching, everybody. This is Opposition. I am done. I'm gonna stop playing Mega Man X games for now. I do have access to X4, but I'm feeling a little tuckered out on it. Suggest me something in the suggestion box below. Otherwise, I think it'll either be either Doom or Star Fox. I'm not sure which one yet, though. Thanks for watching. Until next time.